In this video, you will learn how to modify a cast unit. You will learn how to change the main part of the cast unit. You will also learn how to add concrete parts and embeds to the cast unit. Now that we have created a cast unit, by default, the part with the largest volume of concrete is automatically the main part of the cast unit. In this kind of case where the cross-section of a cast unit changes along the length of the structure, it is a good practice to set the part with the largest cross-section as the main part. So, we'll select the lower floor column as the main part. To change the main part of the cast unit, ensure that the Select Objects in Assemblies or Select Objects in Components selection switch is active. Select the new main part, right-click and select Set as New Main Part of Assembly. As you can see, the lower floor column is highlighted in magenta, so it is now the main part of the cast unit. The secondary concrete parts are highlighted in cyan. Let's add concrete parts and sub-assemblies such as steel parts or embeds to the cast unit. To add a concrete part, go to the Concrete tab, click Cast Unit, and select Add to Cast Unit. Select a concrete part, then select an existing part in the cast unit. Let's add other parts using the context menu. First, select the parts, right-click, then select Add to Cast Unit. If you copy a part that already belongs to the cast unit, the copied part is also automatically added to the cast unit if it touches some of the cast unit parts. Note that if you had reinforcements attached to the concrete parts, they would also be automatically added to the cast unit, so you do not need to add the reinforcements separately. Let's add some lifting hooks to the cast unit. If we use a component to create lifting hooks, the hooks are automatically added to the cast unit. Let's also create a steel plate on top of the column and manually add the plate as a sub-assembly to the cast unit. Go to the Steel tab, click Assembly, then select Add as a sub-assembly. Select the steel plate, and finally, click the cast unit. Tekla Structures adds the steel plate as a sub-assembly to the cast unit. To check that all the needed objects are added to the cast unit, and that the main part is the intended concrete part, go to the ribbon and click the down arrow next to the Inquire Objects command. Then click Assembly Objects, and select a part that belongs to the cast unit. Tekla Structures highlights the main part of the cast unit in magenta, the secondary concrete parts in cyan, the steel sub-assemblies in yellow, and the reinforcement in blue.